Mr. Tarrou again. Okay, we're going to take a look at Simpson's Paradox. This is going to finish our discussion of kind of analyzing two-way tables. I say kind of analyzing two-way tables because we will, when we analyze two-way tables and we're looking for a relationship between two categorical variables, we're not going to actually be able to test if there's an association between those variables until we get to much, much later in the textbook and we learn something called a chi-square goodness of fit test. So, you know, we just got done with the video, we did a bunch of row and column percents and conditional probabilities and just sort of looked at them and, you know, noticed that there were some patterns maybe going on between a couple of categorical variables where you might say, like in the last video, it seemed that the higher your education level was, the more money you made overall, which we certainly hope is true since we're in college and in honors math classes. So that does lead us into, though, you know, we talked about lurking variables, where there's the common response lurking variable and the confounding lurking variable. If you don't remember those, you should go look them up because there's vocab words you're still supposed to know. Well, this idea of lurking variable kind of comes up in something called Simpson's Paradox. That's when you're looking at a two-way table, at least that's the way I'm going to define it, and there's an observed association. You might notice something going on, and let's say, I pulled some information on the internet, on the wiki site, about success of removing kidney stones, and I'll have that reference on my description of this video. And, you know, there's two types of treatments. I didn't discuss what that really was, but we're looking at removing kidney stones, and treatment A has a success rate of 78%, and treatment B has a success rate of 82%. Well, and I'm doing column percents, of course, because we believe that the treatment method is going to help determine or explain whether or not the removal of the stones are successful. So we're doing column percents, 273 divided by 350 is 78%, and so on, you get 82%. Well, if I just looked at this, I would say I want treatment B, because that looks better. Well, we have an observed association in a two-way table, and that is that observed association is reversed when a lurking variable is revealed in a three-way table. Now, a three-way table is simply just two-way tables. And by the way, a two-way table, again, we have a type of treatment and a success or success rate. Those are your two variables, hence the name two-way table. Now, if I come over here and I cover up that and I reveal this three-way table, now what's the three-way table? Well, we've got now the variable of, is it a large or small stone? We have, and so under the small stone, we're going to have our original two variables of treatment type and whether or not there was a success or failure. And we're going to have that same two-way table, or different numbers, but the same type of design, the same two-way table under large kidney stones. So we're making a two-way table of just treatment and success rate into a three-way table, being the size of the stone, the treatment type, and then the success rate. So we have three variables in this table, hence it's called a three-way table. Well, under small stones, treatment A, again, we expect the treatment to help explain the success rate, so we're doing column percents. We had 87 patients get treatment A, and 81 out of 87 were successful, so that's 93%. And in B, we had 270 patients, 234 were successful, and that's 86.7%. Same thing with the large. We have 73% success rate for the large stones for treatment A, and we have a 69% success rate for removing those large kidney stones for treatment B. Now, look at these success rates and how in the three-way table, treatment A is better for the small stones, or at least it has a higher success rate, and it's also higher for the large stones, which of course are going to be tougher to remove, hence the lower rates overall, compared to the two-way table we just looked at a second ago, where when we clumped it all together and we had all the stones, both large and small, in the same grouping, and we're kind of hiding that variable, that lurking variable, it would appear to be a lurking variable in this table, treatment B is better, has a higher success rate, that Simpson's paradox. You observe you observe something in a two-way table, and all those results reverse when you reveal that lurking variable in the three-way table.
Woo! Bam!
Hope these are helping. Go do your homework. Mr. True, out.